Hello, what's up? Welcome to day something, Megan's Songbringer. I don't know what day it is. Today I'm doing an offline, non-stream, YouTube-only video because I'm lazy. I just want to sit down today. I don't really feel like chatting and stuff. I'm just tired today, so I'm just going to sit down and do a YouTube video. If that's all right with you. Anyways, what I'm working on right now is the teleport. So I wanted to get this whole teleport so you can teleport to different places. And one way I could do that was just to create an interface like this where you can just textually choose which point you want to warp to. And I figured that this would be a quick way to prototype it so I could test it out, see how this feels before I commit to doing all the graphics for a really, really nice version of this. So I could do a visual UI here, but I don't know, I kind of like this textual interface for now. I think I might even keep it this way, because it's pretty cool that you got these coordinates, and just basically some, a short description of where you're going to. It's gonna be localized, whatever language you're doing. So, anyways, this works pretty well. You can warp to... warp to your last location, you can warp to Songbringer, and all these are places only if you've been there before. So, you warp back to any of the courage refills you've saved at before, or actually just even been to. So it's pretty neat, and it always remembers your last location if you're warping around. So yeah, you can go back to whatever dungeon you were in or wherever you warped from. So it's actually pretty damn handy to have that ability to just warp pretty fast to places. And so I'm just refining it right now. And just finishing up the last few things, like for example, the ability to cancel. It kind of added this ability to cancel, but it breaks. So I'm going to fix that right now. And anything else I can do to refine it a little bit. And then I'm going to work on my Trello list. See, that cancel fails, so I got some ideas to fix that. But anyways, so yeah, I'll be getting to my Trello list towards the end of this video. And but other than that, I'm just going to shut up and start working, getting my flow. And I do hope these videos are valuable where you can, watch somebody else make a game kind of how I would normally, when it's on the Twitch stream, it's a little different because I'm always talking, and so it's not really how I normally work, or code, or make art, things like that. So this is more of the real thing, the authentic game dev. So without further ado, I'm going to shut up and work, play, whatever you want to call it. Gotta say something here. This is pretty nice, actually, to have the fire dungeon being a different kind of gate item. Most of the gate items so far are pillars that can, like, go away because of an item. The water is nice because it's totally different. The shield tower is also nice because you have to let it hit you. The wall's kind of neat as well because it's totally hidden and you have to use the bling to get over it. But having the fire... the heat damage itself being a gate item in this fire dungeon is pretty neat. I need to mark this like the second I go and change where the fire dungeon is. Alright, so I said for today's video, the next thing I gotta do, one last thing I have to do with this is to go back to the Swordless Dungeon, and there was, because of the way it was designed, you used to get an item, well, just for only 1 week it was like this, but you used to be able to get the Shadrax tier here in the Swordless Dungeon, and so that's a little bit broken now, but more importantly, it's even more broken if you don't have the sword. So this quest here, this adventure, I have the sword. I've found it already, so it's gonna work. I'm gonna be able to get out of here picking up the sword. But if I didn't have the sword before I came into the Swordless Dungeon, like if I was doing a top hat only run, whatever, there would need to be a way for that to work here, where you can exit this dungeon without picking up a sword and getting the sword back if you didn't even have it to start with. So I'm gonna fix that up, and that will be it for this. This is actually, man, my personal notes from playing through the Fire Dungeon right there a little bit, with getting, you know, having to find Shadrax tier, it really made that dungeon a lot more interesting, a lot more of a challenge, and also made it unique compared to other dungeons too. So I'm really excited about that. A gate item that really makes a dungeon unique. So yeah, it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be fun to play the game like that. And also, it's going to be fun to put more of that uniqueness into each kind of dungeon in the future. Something to make it more, you know, puzzles that are unique, gate items that are unique, anything to give a dungeon a unique flavor, or something that you have to have some kind of, you know, strategy that works basically in that dungeon. So yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you all had a great time watching, and that's it. See ya.